Hi, welcome to Papa Ben Bedtime Story. Today, we're going to read a story from a book called Favourite Bedtime Stories, an Illustrated Treasury. The story called The Surprise Sleepover, written by Juliet Groom, illustrated by Lucy Fleming. It was nearly bedtime in number 15 Broad Street, and Cecily Long was just running the bath when the doorbell rang loudly. She peeped through the banister as Mummy opened the door. There, on the step, was a small green crocodile with a large overnight bag.
"I've come for the sleepover,"
announced the crocodile happily, and in he toddled. Cecily rushed down the stairs, two at a time. "A crocodile? Here? For a sleepover? Fantastic!" Mummy was reading a letter the crocodile had passed to her.
"Dear Horace, please come to a fabulous sleepover at number 15, tonight at 7 p.m. Bring your armbands, lots of love, the hippos."
"Oh dear," said Mummy to Daddy. "I think they meant number 15 River Street, not Broad Street. He'll have to go."
"But it's too late to send little crocodile out on his own now,"
cried Cecily.
"He'll have to stay with me. I promise we'll be good. Please!"
Mummy looked at Daddy and then at Horace the crocodile. Horace gave a polite toothy smile, and Cecily hopped from foot to foot and wished the biggest wish of her life. "Please let him stay."
"Okay,"
Mummy smiled.
"He can stay just for tonight, but do not try to make too much noise or mess."
Cecily was very good at adventures, but adventures were sometimes rather noisy and very messy.
"Hooray!"
shouted Cecily.
"He can have the bottom bunk. Come on, Horace."
"Yippee!"
said Horace, and they rushed upstairs two at a time.
"Time for our bath, Horace,"
ordered Cecily. She put in lots of bubbles and lots of toys to play with. It was such fun. Horace was the splashiest bath companion ever. He wore hilarious armbands and Mummy's spotty bath hat. He sang loudly and giggled and splashed, and Cecily sang loudly and giggled and splashed, and soon there was water and bubbles everywhere.
"Cecily,"
shouted Daddy up the stairs.
"Out of the bath and ready for bed."
"Oops!"
gasped Cecily, looking at the mess. But as she hopped out to dry the bathroom, she heard a strange, slightly suspicious, crunching sound.
"Yummy, yummy. Thank you,"
said Horace.
"The bath hat! My boat! Oh no! Give me back that duck!"
shouted Cecily, hurriedly rescuing her favorite duck before Horace could eat it. Cecily thought anxiously of all the toys in her bedroom that Horace might eat.
"Maybe we should have a snack,"
she said as she handed him a stripy towel.
"Ooh, yummy! Yes, please,"
said Horace politely, and he toddled down to the kitchen after Cecily. Daddy made Cecily's most favorite snack, chocolate chip biscuits and hot frothy milk.
"Yummy!"
grinned Horace before Cecily could blink. The heap of the biscuits was gone. There was only one left for Cecily.
"My," said Daddy, "Horace is very hungry for such a small crocodile, isn't he?"
"Yes, please. Thank you,"
said Horace politely. So Daddy made toast and cereal and the biggest midnight feast plate of pancakes Cecily had ever seen. And Horace ate it all. Every bit. He even ate the plate and the salt and the pepper pots.
"Stop, Horace!"
shouted Cecily, whisking the milk jug out of Horace's reach.
Yummy, yummy. Achoo! Sorry, thank you.
Grinned Horace. He snuggled up to Cecily and she laughed.
Are you full at last? Would you like a cuddle?
But as Horace leaned over, he just gobbled up the last of Cecily's biscuit.
Yummy. Thank you.
Cecily was crossed.
That's not fair.
She shouted. There were no biscuits left and no cereal for breakfast, and this was not how a sleepover should work. But she looked at Horace's wobbly, apologetic smile and thought quietly. Maybe crocodiles didn't learn about sharing until they were older. Maybe they'd be better at bedtime story.
Thank you for the supper, Daddy,
she said, and together, Cecily and Horace stomped upstairs to brush their teeth.
Did you bring a toothbrush?
Cecily asked Horace. Horace shook his head.
Would you like to borrow one?
Asked Cecily. Horace nodded. So Cecily told him very strictly that he was not to eat it. And Horace was very, very good. He brushed his teeth till they were sparkling. And then he showed Cecily how to draw toothpaste pictures on the mirror. And it was brilliant. She'd never done that at a sleepover before. In her bedroom, Horace squeezed himself into the bottom bunk with his cuddly sock monkey. Cecily squeezed in next to him, and Mommy read them 5 bedtime stories. Horace and Cecily made the animal noises and sang pirate songs, and it was the loudest, bounciest, best story time ever. At last, Horace yawned a big tooty yawn, and Mommy kissed them both goodnight. Cecily climbed up to her top bunk. Cecily snuggled down. She was a bit cramped, as she had all of her toys with her, just in case Horace got peckish in the night. But that was okay. It had been the best sleepover ever.
Night-night, Horace,
she said.
Yummy, night-night, thank you,
said Horace, and he fell fast asleep. As Cecily drifted off to sleep, she thought about the letter from the hippos and wondered if they'd had a fun sleepover too. Tomorrow, she would write back to them. Mommy and Daddy wouldn't mind if a couple of hippos came for a sleepover one night. She was sure. The end. Thank you for listening and see you again in the next one. Bye.